In the escalating battle between our shoreline and rising sea levels, the shore seems to be losing ground every day. But not, says our Ben Tracy, without a fight.
Well, you have a beautiful view here.
Yep, that's the Atlantic Ocean right there.
30 years ago, Jim Hartshorn looked down at this endless expanse of blue water and decided North Carolina's Outer Banks felt like home.
When you first bought here back in 1993, did you worry about sea level rise? Was that even in your thought process?
I didn't think it would happen quite as quickly as what it did. I thought it wouldn't happen in my lifetime and let the kids worry about it, but I've had to worry about it here the last 10 years.
The ocean has become an increasingly greedy neighbor. Storms are more frequent and more fierce. Parts of these barrier islands, which look a bit like a kid tried to trace the coastline, have retreated more than 200 feet in the last two decades. Some beaches are now losing about 13 feet a year. This past summer, video of the Atlantic claiming yet another beach house just up the road from Jim Hartshorn went viral on Twitter.
Gotta take the good with the bad. It's wonderful to be out here, it's pretty, but you have to know that the ocean's coming for you.
So the water used to come under your house sometimes?
Yes, at high tide.
He's trying to delay that day by reinforcing the pilings that hold up his house and rebuilding this staircase, the old one washed away during a recent storm.
So this year alone, how much have you spent repairing storm damage?
Approximately $22,000 for storm damage.
That's real money.
Oh yeah, that's real money, yep.
Hartshorn and his neighbors are getting help from North Carolina's Dare County, which is spending $25 million to widen 12 miles of coastline along the Outer Banks. A few months ago, waves were hitting his pilings. Now he has a 6-foot-tall dune and a few hundred feet of new beach.
So you got some nice protection here now.
Yep, we really do.
The county also spent $155 million to build this bridge over the water, because Highway 12, the only way in and out, kept flooding. Years ago, the historic Cape Hatteras Lighthouse was moved nearly 3,000 feet inland, an ironic warning of the dramatic climatic changes to come.
You're not going to stop the ocean. You're not going to completely engineer your way out of this challenge. We will have to think about how we move infrastructure, how we move people.
Reed Corbett runs the Coastal Studies Institute on the Outer Banks.
Yes, sea level has changed in our past, but it's changing at a rate that we haven't seen before.
He took us out to the marsh where he and other scientists collect soil samples that are a peek into the past.
The soil basically gives you a history of what this marsh has done.
He says their research shows the rate of sea level rise here has doubled in the past 100 years.
That's a pretty aggressive acceleration.
Yeah, and we're just starting to see the ramp. You know, we're looking at a foot rise in the next 30 years. That's going to impact most homeowners on the Outer Banks during their mortgage. And so it's not about putting it off to the next generation. It's happening today. We're seeing those impacts today.
Sea level rise is accelerating due to global warming, caused mainly by the burning of fossil fuels. It's causing the world's ice sheets and glaciers to melt. A new NASA report says sea levels along U.S. coastlines are expected to rise as much as 12 inches by 2050, with the Southeast and Gulf Coasts seeing the most change. By 2100, 13 million Americans could be displaced and $1 trillion worth of property inundated.
East Coast cities such as Miami are already struggling with flooding, even on sunny days, and hurricanes and storm surge along the Gulf Coast are expected to get more intense.
So the intent here is to provide multiple lines of defense. We're going to build from this line out.
Kelly Burks Copes is with the Army Corps of Engineers in Galveston, Texas. It's planning to build a system of massive gates here designed to fend off 22 feet of storm surge and 43 miles of sand dunes to protect against rising seas and stronger hurricanes. The project is estimated to cost $31 billion.
It will be the largest infrastructure project in the nation for the next 20 years.
Is this where we're at with climate change, that we have to do things like this?
I think that it's a necessity. If we're going to continue to live close to the ocean, if we want to live here on the coast, then we have to provide a level of defense.
This is where your home was?
And I have the address to prove it.
Oh, man. Okay.
Right here.
Right here.
A whole house. Not even room for a toilet now.
Jane Tolini thought she had it made.
So you can see where I was. This is your house here.
Yeah.
Living high above the Pacific on the cliffs of Pacifica, California.
There was a 20-foot front yard, a 900-square-foot house. Then there was like maybe 25, 30 feet until you came to this white picket fence in the backyard, and it felt like I could get drunk, roll out the door, hit the fence, and I would be safe. I thought I was golden.
She was wrong. Punishing El Nino storms in 1998 turned her California dream home into a nightmare. She woke up one morning to find her yard was gone.
There was nothing, zip. And it was terrifying. Now, if somehow this idiot had gotten up, walked to that sliding glass door, opened it, and stepped out, I would have stepped into space.
You would have fallen right out of your house.
Right out of my house. That's how undercut I was. Here's the house, here's the land. I mean, it was like, how did this happen? And so quickly. And I slept through most of it.
That morning, she called friends to help her quickly move out before her house and 12 others had to be torn down and pushed into the ocean. Since then, entire apartment complexes have realized that they too picked a losing fight with the Pacific. Of course, erosion has always been a part of life on the West Coast, but scientists say climate change is accelerating it, threatening nearly all of California's 1,000 miles of coastline and billions of dollars worth of real estate.
If you believe there's going to be more water, then there's going to be less land on every coast around the world.
And having lived on the leading edge of climate change, Tolini has no doubts about who has the upper hand.
Mother Nature's always going to win. And she has got a bone to pick with the human race, and I don't blame her.